about the Nidan Purva Rog group, everything. So today we will do only clinical review and only my clinical experience basis on some formulations and the diagnosis way. So thank you all of you to join this session. First, before we go to Ayurvedic approach or Ayurvedic view, I would like to tell little detail about the diagnosis way of the modern point of view also. What happened in Ayurveda, like we only have detailed description of Pushta or Visarga, like so many skin related issues, but we don't have the photographs of it in our any of the texts. So where we are no feeling lacuna is on the photograph level and sometimes in the diagnosis level too. Because in Vicharchika, we have only one shlok. And we have the symptoms like Kandu, Srav, etc. But when the patient will come to our clinic, we cannot diagnose properly whether it is eczema or it is Vicharchika or it is lichen, psoriasis, any of the modern terminology. So today, first of all, we will go to the modern point of view and we will see the different diagnoses according to that. And later we will do our Ayurvedic point of view. So as we all know, 1 minute. Okay. As we all know that eczema is a word coming from the Greek word, it is a boiling tiny vesicles that are often seen in the early acute stage of the disorders. Sometimes we listen the word dermatitis also and we will think that is it eczema and dermatitis are the same disorders or it is anything else, but in the broader spectrum, dermatitis we can use instead of eczema also. It is inflammation of the skin on the epidermal layer mainly. So here, today we will see eczema as it is over 20 to 30% of new cases. Generally we found that it is dermatitis or eczema. In the modern or the, in our allopathy doctors or our allopathy colleagues, when they cannot treat or the patient will fed up with all the allopathic treatments, they will come to the Ayurvedic doctors. So here we have to think about acute and chronic eczema as well, because we will not find our every patient in the acute stage. Generally, we will see our eczema patients in the chronic stages. So there are many classifications, we will do it later, but in acute stage, totally we will see these all symptoms or one or two symptoms sometimes in our patients. So in the acute stage, edema in the epidermis layer, which form the intra-epidermal vesicles, which may be in a larger blisters or it may be ruptured. So we will see first of all weeping and later crusting. The second one is itching and burning. They are the main symptoms in our patients. Erythema we can see on their skins. Third one is blistering in the acute stage and in some patients where we can see clade, according to Ayurveda, we can see blisters on their skin, redness, papules and swellings, considering in the acute stage of erythema. And the most important thing is ill-defined border and scales. So that is main differentiate that ill-defined borders, if we will see on leg or on hands or any part of the body, first of all, we should think about eczema or dermatitis. Now in chronic stage, as in the photograph, we can see that it is less exudative, or you can say it is vesicular plus crusting more. It is more dry, scaly and thickened. Generally, it is pigmented. Mostly, it is hyperpigmentation is there. Generally, blackish or reddish or maroonish color is there. And we can see fissured and lichen application in the later stage of chronic eczema because of continuous scratching on the particular part. Main thing is, what is different diagnosis between eczema and psoriasis or the lichen? Because in the clinic, we generally got confused about eczema and psoriasis. First of all, I want to share the sequence of histological events in eczema. Generally, first is vesications. The second stage is whipping. Third stage is crusting. And the fourth stage is lichenification. That is the stages of eczema from acute to chronic. And so many causes, there are causative factors for eczema. But what we are seeing in the clinical appearance is absence of a sharp margin. That is most identical or the cardinal sign of eczema. After that, generally in eczema, no sharp margin, when we will see sharp defined margin in psoriasis and lichen. The second thing is, in the eczema, we can see epidermal disruption. So, comparative to psoriasis, there is no significant sign of any of the epidermal disruption. Eczema, generally we can see, is asymmetrical in one part of body. But in the psoriasis or lichen, we generally say it is a symmetrical, means if it is on one leg, we can see on the both the legs. So that is also a main differentiated diagnosis between them. In eczema, it is mostly red inflamed skin, where in psoriasis or lichen, generally we will take psoriasis actually, because lichen is also very different than psoriasis. So here in the psoriasis, we can take thick silvery scales. Eczema is generally exogenous cause. Mainly the factors are from external side, that is irritant contact or the allergens from outside, where in psoriasis it is starting from endogenous any factors like hereditary autoimmune disease. It is considered as a from the system inside. Eczema is the transient basis, on and off it will occur and sometimes dissolve itself. And you can find in infants too, right? So that is the main difference. When we see in infant or in early childhood, it is mostly eczema. When in psoriasis, it is chronic. And second is lifelong disease. It will not go on and off its own. And we generally found it is in adult. So in the photograph, you can see the differential diagnosis of both. Here I will start with the classification of the eczema. Mainly, we will see eczema, there is a different zones. Exogenous causes, they are irritant, allergic and photodermatitis. So we will start with irritant contact dermatitis. Later on, there is other classifications like atopic seborrheic dermatitis, discoid or nummular. Then gravitational, asymptomatic, and neurodermatitis. So there are so many classifications as per the conventional science. So starting, we will do irritant contact dermatitis according to Ayurveda actually, because I will tell some the Ayurvedic point of view also. Irritant contact dermatitis or allergen contact dermatitis, we can consider it as a dushi vishjanya kushta. Because dushi vish is also a causative factor for kushta nidan or visha, even you can take it. So here irritant contact dermatitis first. Our most of the eczema cases, we can see there are irritant contact dermatitis. It is an inflammatory reaction to the skin, of the skin to any of the physical, chemical or biological agents. So either it is irritant or allergens. Mainly we can see on hand and forearm, as it is some in the industrial zone or you can say as a occupational dermatitis also. In the household work, we can see in our mates or even on ourselves sometimes with the hard chemicals or detergents, soap, then alkali, any of the alkalis and solvents. So because of these chemicals, our skin will give reactions to such type of hard chemicals. And if our skin is very soft, delicate or sensitive, then and then only we can see such type of irritant contact dermatitis. Now second one is, I will not take any of the modern part of treatment because I am doing pure Ayurvedic practice. generally, I am using the modern books or any of the modern equipment only for diagnosis purpose. So I will not go with detail about the treatment of each of this dermatitis. The second one is allergic contact dermatitis. Actually, the causative factors not clear in such type because allergens are so many and what allergies the person is facing, we cannot say. So the mechanism is that it is a delayed hypersensitivity. And for this allergic contact dermatitis happen, one needs previous contact to induce such allergies. So once a person is allergen with any of the things or substance, again to produce such type of dermatitis, they need again the second contact. Specific chemicals for reactions, so every person will not get such type of dermatitis. Later skin will react to allergens like single exposure or prolonged exposures. Mainly we can see this type of dermatitis on areas like eyelids, hands or feet, or gravitational ulcer. So this type of allergies we are generally see in the individual workers like hairdressing or who is working with flower shop or dentistry. So that is a different zone where we get allergic dermatitis. Now, third one is occupational. This one is the second most common dermatitis in our every eczema group. So, mostly hands are affected, 80 to 90% of in the cases. And because of some irritant or some allergies or sometimes combinations of all, we can get occupational. Like in some factories, in petroleum factories also, when the person has to work with petroleum products, some plastic factories where they are continuous contact with some chemicals which will give them allergic reactions, mainly nickel. The third, the most important is atopic eczema. Atopy, the word actually comes from Greek word and it is meaning is without a place. So atopy is a state in which actually it is IgE, the immunoglobulin E, which responds to any of that environmental allergy. So this may be with or without other atopic disease conditions. Like so many times we will see our patients, like patient is suffering from asthma, and simultaneously we can see some skin rashes on the body or itching pattern. So I generally, when I will take any history taking with the skin patient, I always ask about asthma or breathlessness history, because actually it is more important. We can diagnosis or we can differentiate diagnosis between eczema or regular itching or any other disease condition. So this is a most important diagnosis factor, asthma. The second one is food allergies, and third one is hay fever. Hay fever is not found in India so well. So it is generally in European countries or the where the pollens are there in California, like states, America. So the hay fever with eczema, I have patients in California right now, and another one is in UK. But in India, I didn't see so many patients of hay fever or like such type of condition. In India, we see asthma plus eczema in many of our patients, right? So this is most important history taking point. Generally, there is inheritance. So the strong genetic component is responsible for this, and it is from childhood even. So from childhood, if any of the family member has atopic eczema, mainly from maternal side, and in Ayurveda also it is told that our matruj bhava, so every soft organs our body comes from matruj bhava. So maternal side of any of the skin problems, the child will take that as an inheritance. So 3% of infants are affected with this, mainly 75% cases generally before 6 months of age, and 80% of cases before 5 years of age, we can see the onset of this disease, atopic eczema or atopic dermatitis. Now, the atopic dermatitis, I am not taking this disease in a deep. I just take the different characteristic with the age. In the childhood, the symptoms will be different. In the adulthood and in the geriatric, the symptoms will be changed. So the main cardinal sign is itching first, with scratching and poor sleep. And this is the seesaw with asthma. Means sometimes if asthma is there, the atopic dermatitis will decrease, and when atopic dermatitis will increase, asthma will decrease. So it is like a seesaw with asthma, if the patient having both the atopic disease. First, in infancy, we can see vesicular plus VP, mostly on face and diaper areas. So from there, we can start, or we can judge our disease part. The second one is in childhood. Generally, we can see the same patient in childhood. They can feel the dry or leathery or excoriated skin, mainly on elbow, knees, flexures, wrists and ankles. This is the place of the appearance of dermatitis, where it is produced, it is most important. Because when we see wrist or ankle, we should consider the different diagnosis of other diseases, which also we can see on wrist and ankles. So we can clearly sometimes go on the direct, go to the disease part, or the we can directly diagnose the disease name on the base of the sthana. So here, elbow, knee, flexure, wrist and ankle are most important. Now in adulthood, same as childhood, we can see all the symptoms, but again, because it would be now chronic stage, we can see lichenification and widespread on face, hands and trunks. So here, that is atopic dermatitis is most important, because it will start from infant level to our adulthood. Now the later one is seborrheic dermatitis. I think sir took it, Amit Chavan sir took it very deeply, seborrheic eczema dermatitis. So we will not go deep into this. The main part is it is greasy, thin and yellowish scalp. That is the most important thing, and mostly we will see on the seborrheic parts of the body, or you can say it hairy parts, or where the sebaceous glands are there, you can see seborrheic dermatitis on particular parts. So it will be easy for us to diagnose the seborrheic dermatitis. Now, the spread of glomerular eczema. Generally, when we see any round patches, we think about kidney infections all the time, or most of the time. So this is a differentiate diagnosis, where you can see that all the round, or point shaped patches are not tinea. It may be glomerular eczema too. And so many skin diseases have the same type of pattern. So first here, in the glomerular eczema, it is chronic stage induced eczema. The second one is mainly on limbs of male. So here we can consider the sex as male and on limbs. It generally produces multiple point shaped crusted plaque with severe itching. So here it is the main differentiate diagnosis with tinea also. In the both tinea and glomerular, itching is there, but severe itching is more than glomerular eczema. Plus they are multiple in number, point shape, and they are not merged every time. So it is a main differentiate, and sometimes it is vesicular and whipping patch too. Now this one is most important, I consider this as the Svedvaha Stroto Dushti Janya Kushtha, because we are not taking Svedvaha Srotos in our any of the Kushtha Sam, but if we are go with our Purva Karma, that is Asvedana Atisvedana, words are there, and here we can consider this as Asvedana or Svedvaha Dushti or Svedvaha Avrodhi. In the modern point of view, that is the same thing is there. It is a desidrotic eczema. So by heat or the emotional disturbance, it will increase. So if the patient is complaining about, if they are going in summer or in very moisture or humid atmosphere, they are facing such type of small vesicles or the blisters on sole, palm or on finger mainly. We will not see in another part of body. So this is also a good character to diagnose this type of eczema. And it is most unpleasant form of eczema because severe itching is there and it doesn't look good on the skin also. So it the main complications is recurrent lymphangitis with this, or secondary infections may be there, and that's why it is not good. The letter is stasis or gravitational eczema. In our varicose vein patients, generally we can see such type of eczema on and off. It is because of venous insufficiency which leads to poor circulation, and that's why we will see on the gravitational parts on the body. So mainly it is on the legs, lower legs, with or without varicose vein and edema. So every varicose vein patient will not get infected with eczema, but yes, mostly they have to face one or another type of eczema in their life. This is most important. It is asymmetrical. So the asymmetrical is identical point between another eczema and gravitational eczema or other skin diseases. Now another form is osteotrophic, that is xerotic eczema, and in our old age patients we will see this is very very common, mainly on legs, but in our patient we can see in on hands also, and sometimes on scalp also. So right now I have a patient of such xerotic eczema all over body, and actually she is facing such status on and off since I think she is now 68 years, but she is facing say since 50 years, means 50 year of age. So she is facing early stage of degeneration in their life, and that's why xerotic eczema is common in such type of patients. According to Ayurveda, that is the vata predominant stage. Sorry. So in our vata prakriti patient, we can see xerotic eczema very often, and in the old age it is also vata pradhan avastha. So this is very common. This picture is actually, you can see little bit redness and superficial fissures also, but in generally sometimes we can see only dry skin, only scalings, little scalings or the fissured, normal fissures like condition, without any hyper or hypopigmentations. So mainly in dry weather or area with low humidity in winter, over wash or over bath, and overuse of diuretics, and in hypothyroidism patients we can see such type of conditions. So according to Ayurveda, it is totally the patient of vata prakriti or vata pradhan kushta, and another is rasakshaya. In the rasakshaya or rasagat vata also we can see this pattern. Now the next one is neurodermatitis. This is most important, and actually we see such type of patient in our clinic, because in this type of patient there is no conventional treatment or modern allopathy part of treatment or the result in neurodermatitis, LSC, lichen simplex chronicus, and lichen simplex you can say in the normally, and chronicus in the later stage. So the word neuro means actually it is related with our psychological involvement much more than the physical involvement only. So here, repeated rubbing and scratching leads to lichenification. Lichenification is simply the thickening of the skin, the epidermal and upper layer of the skin. This one is a single. Single means single patches are there. It is not multiple patches or merge in each other. So it is a single only. Generally itchy, very itchy. Lichenified fleck with hyperpigmentation. We can see in the female nape of neck, in the men on the leg part, and in the both the sexes in genital area. I will show one case on good result on that on the end of our discussion. The another form is napkin dermatitis. We can see in our so many infant patients, because the overuse of diaper nowadays, because of diaper or pants, the fecal material and urine, or because of the ammonia from the urine, all will leads to growth of bacteria in the local area. So damp area or moisture, we can see the glazed or shiny eczema or dermatitis on the genital parts or in the anus area. Generally, they are weeping, erythema, pain and irritation, and that's why a child cannot sleep properly, and we cannot introduce any of the medicines on that stage. Only we can do external treatment like garlic, chuna, dusting, as per the Ayurvedic terminology, because in modern, each and every dermatitis have their different medications, and we will not go deep into that. So here, this is all about diagnosis from modern point of view. Now, according to Ayurveda, first of all, I will give you a short, the reference about twak in the relation with dosha dhatu in mala. Though you all know deeply about that, but according to eczema part, I want to give some emphasis on some part particularly. So here, as we know that pancha bhautik sangathan is there on twak. How we will consider with the modern part of view. So according to in the Panch Mahabhut, if we will consider Akash Mahabhut, so the Romkop Svedvah Sutras, we can correlate with Akash Mahabhut, where we can see the micro channels or the hollow parts of Akash Mahabhut, the Vayu, which gives Parshan. So every Vatvahi Nadi or the tactile sensation on the skin actions, we can consider with Vayu. Same in with the Agni, all the color, lustre, or the we can say the absorption capacity or the digestion capacity locally with any of the oil or any of the medicines, that is for from Agni, Prabha, Kanti, and Varna. So our complexions, hyper or hyperpigmentations, all are considered because of Agni. In Jal Mahabhut, our sweat secretion and Ras Rakta Samvaham. So the circulation portion is because of Jal Mahabhut. And Prithvi Mahabhut, which will give tightness or the stability. So our subcutaneous fat, epidermis and loma, we can tell about it because of Prithvi Mahabhut. Now I skip Twak and Dosha correlation. We will discuss in the latest slides. I will go directly with Twak and Dhatu relation. The first Ras Dhatu is all you know, that is considered as Twak also. So Priyan Karma is of Ras Dhatu. Udak Dharakala we can consider as Twak. So here it is correlated with lymph, extra or intracellular fluids. All are we can consider in Ras Dhatu. This is only a correlation. We cannot directly judge with everything the same thing, like Ras is equal to Rasika. We should not do like this. We only consider Ras Dhatu with only Priyan Karma, where we can see Priyan Karma everything or every ऑफ द सेल्यूलर लेवल, इट इज अ रस कर्म. सेम वन इज अ रक्त. रक्त इज नॉट इक्वल टू ब्लड. सो वी शुड नॉट टेक रक्त इज इक्वल टू ब्लड. एनी ऑफ द जीवन कर्म इन एनी पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी वी कैन कंसिडर इज अ रक्त धातु. सो ये रक्त इज गिविंग जीवन वर्ण प्रसादन एंड मांस पुष्टि. सेम एज अ मांस दैट इज उपधातु ऑफ त्वक. सो इट इज गिवन लेपन कर्म. मेद अगेन इट इज अ स्नेहन. सो इन सेबरिक डर्मेटाइटिस वी कैन सी दैट इज इट इज अ मेद प्रकोप और मेद दृष्टि बिकॉज देर द स्नेहन कर्म विल नॉट डू प्रॉपर वर्क. द स्वेद दैट इज मेद मल क्लेद विद्रुति टू कीप इट मॉइस्चर. इन ड्राई एक्जिमा वी कैन सी दैट स्वेद स्रोत दृष्टि इज देर. इन इवन अवर एसिड्रोटिक एक्जिमा ऑल्सो वी हैव सी दैट इट इज अ स्वेद स्रोत दृष्टि. Our nail hair, which is related with our skin also, they are part of asti dhatu. And twakgat sneha, which we can see on a sebum part also, that is majja. And our new cell growth, and that is called as ropan karma of shukra dhatu. So here, twak with sthulmal, twak with sukshmamal, I just make it, give the relations where we can understand about the sukshmamal also. Now, in our clinical Ayurvedic point of view, when we come to know that our skin is good, then we have to see our Twak Sar. What is mentioned in Ayurvedic text, the Sartha of Purusha, we should consider Twak Sartha. Then we can see our patient is now on the right track. So, this is a diagnosis point of view. Now, we will come to the Vicharchita, first the Nirukti side. It is a cracking of skin, mainly occur on the skin of hand and legs. Actually, it is only called as Vicharchika. In another part of body, like on scalp or another part, in the classical text, it is not mentioned. The second one is V plus Charcha is equal to a form of cutaneous eruptions, which itch and scale. So here in the text, we can see Vicharchika as a Shudra Kushta. In Charak Samhita, it is considered as Kaphatmak Vyadhi. It is Kaphajanya in Nidan and Chikitsa. But Sushrut has a different opinion. He considered as a Pittajanya Vyadhi. And in Madhav Nidan, it is called as Vata Pittajanya. Another reference is, we can say that in Vagbhat, the particularly told is Lasikadhya. So they are taking Lasika as a main factor in the Vicharchika. Indu also wrote the same thing as Jala Prayaman, in which watery discharge are more, it is called as Vicharchika. In Kashyap also, Vrana, Vedana and Pak. In Vicharchika, we can see such type of symptoms, which are Sadhya. In Bel Samhita, Shava and Rakta Varana, there are two types of Vicharchika are mentioned, which are Sadhya. That is Praklenna Sravo and Mansena Upachitata. So now, after this reference, we will take a short, the detail about Hetu, that Aharaj, Viharaj, Manas and Agantush. Why Hetu is most important? Because if many of our patient, and I, most of in my Kushta or skin related patient, I totally stop Lavana, salt, from the food, and after that I will get a proper result. Otherwise, with salt intake, patient will not get properly cured, and the treatment will go 6 months to 1 year also. So here, the most important is our ahar, and the rasa means lavan and katu. That is ati sevan of lavan, katu, madhu, and kshar. They leads to generally kapha prakop mainly, and over salt and spicy food. With the Ushna Katu Guna Vritti, which aggravates Pitta and Rakta Dushti. So here mainly we can see Kapha, Pitta and Rakta Dushti with our Ahara. As being a Dravidian scholar, I always emphasize on Guna, because on the base of Guna of Rog and Rogi, and again we are selecting our plants on the basis of Guna actually. So Guna is most important, and I just try to correlate how this guna of a particular dosha will increase. So second one is, this all hetus are common in Pushta. So all you know that alcohol or any vinegar in Chinese sauces also, we can see vinegars like another fermented foods. Because of that Ushna Tikshna, Ashuvidahi gun increase, and which leads to Pitt and Rakta Dushti. So according to the Charak, it is Kapha Janya, but according to the Sushrut, it is Pitta Janya Vyadhi. The third one is mustard or overuse of mustard sauce or such type of hing mustard like Ushna Dravya or Ushna Vidahi Dravya, Katura Satma Dravya, Pitta, Ushna Gun of Pitta Vruddhi is there. Now, in the Vihar, I am not taking every, the Ahar Vihara Jhetu. I will take only which are related with eczema mainly. So here, Chita Maruta Sansparshat means exposure of cold wind. Mainly, we are using AC nowadays and we are coming out directly in the normal environment, either it is humid or dry. So body will not equilibrium with such changes, that is Krama Virutta. Because of Shita Guna of Vata and Kapha, it aggravates Bodha Dosha. Again, in cold water bath and swimming, continuous overuse of bath or wash, we can see so many eczemas. In third, it is the Diva Sap, indulgence of day sleep. It increases Guru Guna of Kapha. So, Kleda Vruddhi is there, Agni Mandir is there, and after all, they will lead to any of the Kushta, either eczema or any. Now, Asamyak Vaman and Chardi Vekdharan. So, suppression of urges, or if we will do another over Asamyak Vaman. So, mainly, I have seen so many patients in government hospital in Jamnagar, where if the patient will not follow Vaman or the Panchakarma Paricharya, and if he came in the stage like Asamyak Vaman or not proper Ayog of Vaman or Atiyog of Vaman. Generally in Ayog of Vaman, the eczema or such type of rashes will increase after Panchakarma. So this is most important. If you are doing Vaman Karma, please take care of this. It leads to Kapha and Pitta Dushti. Utkleshit Pitta followed by Vata. So here Udan and Vyanvayu Prakopa are also there. In generally winter, we can see our eczema patient, the symptoms are increased much more because of Shita and Rukshita of Vata. And in Varsha Rutu again, we can see the increased patient of eczema, but it is because of Shita Guna of Kapha plus Amasanche. So here, Shita Guna in Shishira and Shita Guna in Varsha, both are Guna are same, but in Shishir it is with Ruksha, where in Varsha it is Shita with Kleda or Ama. So the both the pathogenesis of eczema will be different and the treatment part also will be different. So the third most important factor is Mana or emotional factors. Here stress or negative emotions, mainly grief, anxiety, guilt, frustration, suppressed emotions, like in our Corona time, I literally see so many patients starting with normal eczema, normal itching to eczema actually. So because of stress and so many negative emotions around right now. So mainly our skin patients are increased in numbers right now with some psychological involvement. So here, what psychological involvement there and how it is relation with skin? Because this all emotions affect the hypothalamus plus adrenaline glands. With this negative impact or the emotions, it will lead to low immunity. And because of low immunity, generally, first of all, we our defense mechanism, and that is skin, will be affected with this negative emotion. Another factors which are very important in day-to-day practice, this is out of our text. All the factors are not in our text. That is Kita Dansha, any insect bite. I saw three of my patients that only with mosquito bite continues on the legs for so many months. She will get no, she would do the produce eczema type pattern, and later it is really a dry eczema she faced. And this is Kita Dansha, and it is we can consider in Dushi Vishajanya Kushta. So if we will treat Dushi Vishajanya Kushta, we can come or we can reduce such type of eczema. The second one is Krimi, external or internal. It is also one of the positive factors for any of the Kushta. Then Asatmya Ahar Vihar, you know very deep about so many Viruddha Ahar and all. Also, we will not go deep in that. Then Krama Viruddha, like AC and the normal weather, same one is the heaty area, so outside heat, and we just come at home and take cold water. So it is also Krama Viruddha, Viruddha Ahar, and Vegdharan. You all know detail about Ayurvedic part as well. We will take some modern parts like diaper, then soaps, perfumes, dye, any cosmetics, and some metal compounds like nickel, mercury, our even rings, what we are wearing in our fingers, that is also a factor for contact dermatitis. In rubber, so many patients are facing leg eczema because of rubber slippers or some synthetic slippers and all. Leather allergies are there, we can see in our patients with leg eczema mainly. And exposure to sunlight, it is also one heat eczema, that is a type of eczema in modern part of view. I didn't mention it because we cannot see so many patients of heat eczema, but as yes, it is there because of exposure in sunlight. So we all know Kushta, Nidana, Tridosh Prakopaj, that is Swak Rakta Mans, Ambu Shaithilya, everything we know. So we will not go deep into the pathogenesis, because in Vichachika they didn't give any separate pathogenesis. So now we will take our most important part, that is Samprapti, three doshas. But in acute condition, this is not mentioned in text. This is practical view. In acute condition, cough and pitta predominant. Vata is less in proportion. But in chronic stage, with cough, and the second one is Vata. And generally, in so many patients, Vata is most predominant dosha. Cough is second and pitta is less. So this is a totally practical my approach. I will not, I cannot say no, that you can believe same. You just do practical things and believe it is there or not, or consider your patient and dosh accordingly. The second one is dosha, that is Swak Rakta Mans and Lasika. The third one is Srotas. Prana and Udakvah Srotas are involved. You all will think about how the prana will effect on skin and all, but it is also another lecture, how the prana will know the relations with skin. But yes, prana udak, rasa rakta mamsa, svedvah and manovah srotas are there. If we will consider all these srotas and treat accordingly, it will give you definitely result. Then main srota drushti is sangha, and in svedvah srota drushti, sangha, sometimes ati sveda, so there ati pravartan is also there. In vyaktasan mainly is a talk, and sushrut it is called as gatreshu, means any part of the body. Adhishtan is mainly tamra and vedini, our layers of skin according to Ayurveda, that is fourth and fifth, where kushta is given. And in the sadhya and asadhya, 1 minute. The doshic involvement, Vata, Pitta and Kapha. So we will not go detail. Just see the photos. How we will see and how we will differentiate diagnosis with the doshic. The first one is Vata. There Shul and Rukshita is there. You can see the pigmentation, hyperpigmentation. The second one is redness, where Sphota, Raktima, Daha, Vaivarna, राग एंड उष्णता इज देयर. द थर्ड वन इज कफ. वी कैन सी पेस्टुल्स क्लेद समटाइम्स पस एंड स्त्राव फॉर्मेशन एंड कंडू इज देयर. सो दिस इज अ डिफरेंशियल डायग्नोसिस एज पर आई गो ऑन वात पित्त एंड कफ. ओके द लेटो दिस इज अ मेन डिफरेंशियल डायग्नोसिस अकॉर्डिंग टू आयुर्वेद. सुश्रुत told about chronic stage. It is a dry eczema where in charak it is called as wet eczema. So the two slokas we will see in the charak it is sakandu pitika syava bahusra vicharchika means wet eczema. So you can see all the symptoms and the picture. The same one is according to charak it is a dry eczema. It is raju adikandu rujayan dukshata. So in the ayurvedic point of view there are so many differential diagnoses. Vicharchika with Pama Kachu, and the diagnosis points are given below. Variety of lesions, colors, sites, signs, and symptoms. And in the three diseases, they are on the different site and signs. I just consider correlate Charmakhya Pushta with neurodermatitis as per the slope. Actually, it is not given in any text. Charmadal, that is irritant dipodermatitis, even in Ahiputna, it is also correlate with diaper rashes. Either Charmadal, you can see the slope and symptoms, and our irritant diaper dermatitis patient, we can correlate directly with each other. Here I told about desidrotic eczema, that is Svedvaha Srota Dushti. You can see the pictures and our Svedvaha Srota Dushti Lakshana, Shava Rakta Sveta Bahustrava Ati Ruja Rukshita, and later it go in the eczema part. Now the Chikitsa Sutra, Nidan Parivarjan Sansojan Sansamandhi are the theme of Ayurveda. I consider Charak Sanhita as a main treatment protocol. Charak Sutra San Dosha Upakram, I treat according to this sequence. In acute stage we will go with Langan, Rukshan and Samvana, where in chronic stage in Vata Janya mainly or in the later stage it is Bruhan, Snehan, Svedan. That are most important. Now in acute stage, langan, first of all langan in bahu dosh avastha or in aam avastha, we will do langan. Now in charak sanhita, langan has different types. So here we can take dipan, pachan, laghu ahar, and even panchakarma. Four procedures are there which is mentioned in langan types. That is vaman, virechan, basti, and rakta mokshan. I just give a glimpse at what I am doing in clinic. In Vaman, in Kapha Pradhan Avastha, in wet eczema, we can do Vaman. And even in Pitta Dominant also, we can do Vaman plus Virechan. So mainly numular and inflamed eczema, we can do Virechan. Generally in later stage, in chronic stage or in dry eczema, we can do Basti. So the one case later I will discuss, LSC, I did Basti and it will got good result. So the fourth one is Rakta Mokshan. Here leech therapy will definitely work, and later Siravet also you can do. Nasya, mainly if you feel that patient is more involved with Manovaha Srotas or psychological disturbance, then Nasya is a good choice with the Shirodhara. Now in the Rukshan, Ruksha Aha Vihar and Avachuranan. Generally in wet eczema or in oozing, you can do Rukshan and external Avachuranan. The third one is Stambhana. Bahu Strav Avastha, Bahu Strav or Bahu Dosha. With the Kshalan and Parishik externally, with the Kashay Rasatmak Dravya like Trifla Ludhra Dekwat, you can do Dhavana. So it will give good result. In dry eczema, with Rukshan and Stambhana, the condition will aggravate. So don't do it in dry eczema. In dry eczema or in the chronic stage like neurodermatitis and LSE or in xerotic eczema, we can do snehana. After niram condition, internal snehan should be applied. Ghrit, tail or yamak. Mostly we are doing ghritpan in our patient. The external side, Lepa or the Snehana Lepa should be used. Lepa Pichur Augaha, that is Ghritpan, Telpan and Yamak. Mostly we are using this oil in Pitta Dominant, that is Shatadhot Ghrita. कफ डोमिनेंट स्टेज और कफ क्लेदादि के मरीच आदि ऑयल विल बी बेटर एंड इन यमक महातिक्त घृत करंज ऑयल गिव गुड रिजल्ट हियर यमक मीन्स तेल एंड घृत घृत टूगेदर सो वी कैन मेक आवर ओन घृत एंड तेल टूगेदर एंड मेक यमक स्नेह इन तेल पान मरीच आदि ऑयल आइदर अर्क तेल इज ऑल्सो बेस्ट गिविंग रिजल्ट इन एक्जिमा The second one is Sneh Svedan, external as well as internal. Sorry. Now external Svedan, how we can do that is Pradeha Pralepa, Nadi Svedan, Patra Potli Sved. Here when see dry eczema, first we should apply Snehan externally and then Svedan. And we should not do all these procedures in wet eczema. So please be consider this. Now, why I am doing the Tribhuvan Kirti Ras? Because Tribhuvan Kirti Ras will produce Svedan, means it is a Svedjana. So, in our patient, in dry eczema, the main problem is a Svedan on that local patch. So, we have to make Svedan. Svedan se kya hoga? Svedan will give Kled Vidruti. To vaha Kled rahega, Kled shuru hoga ya moisture hoga. तो वो स्किन सॉफ्ट होगी एंड द लाइकेनिफिकेशन विल रिड्यूस ऑटोमेटिकली सो दैट्स व्हाई स्वेदन इज मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट ओनली एक्सटर्नल स्वेदन विल नॉट हेल्प वी हैव टू डू इंटरनल स्वेदन विथ त्रिभुवन कीर्ति लाइक द्रव्य और मंजष्ठादि द्रव्य सो द लाइन ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट आई एम कंसिडरिंग लाइन ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ रस एंड वीर्य इन द वेट एक्जिमा तिक्त कषाय रस शुड बी A plant should be used and in dry eczema, tikta madhur rasatmak should be used. In the video also, wet eczema is mainly cough dominant, so we should consider anushna or ushna and sometimes ushna even we have to use. But when in dry eczema, we have to use ushna virya dravyas because it will give svedan and so the dryness will decrease. Here, the first one is dipan pachan, later kled shoshan. If wet eczema is there, third one is vishahar chikitsa, rakt prasadan, pachak yog as per the dhatugat jhara pachak yog given in the charak samhita, mutral dravya, pitta sarak rechan, vibandhar, kandugna, kromigna, kushthagna and vanya. These all are line of treatment. As per our patient, we have to select our line of treatment individually. I just give some of the formulations which we are using in clinic and you all have to not take it as it is, but you have to read everything and then follow the formulation as per your patient's condition. So as Dipan Pachan, we can use Shadang Paniya or Padma Kadikwar. Shadang Paniya with or without Sunthi as per the condition of patient. The second one is Padma Kadi Kwat, where we have to deduct Shunthi from the Shadang Paniya and add Padmak instead of that. It is Kadi Kwat that is good in Pitta Prakruti persons. Mustajal, even you can take Nagaradi or the that one is Trikatu, Shadushan or Panchakol. Even Dipan Pachan, I am using Sudarshan Ghanvati also. In Pitta Prakruti patients, if we are introducing Pitta Rasatmak Dravya, then it will give good pachan of Sama Pitta. So, Pitta Rasatmak Dravya also. So, either Katu or Pitta. The second one is Anuloman and Rechan, which is most important because of Vibandha or the Sangha in our Antragat area or in our intestinal area. Generally, we see the toxic materials or the poor circulations are there and so we should do anuloman in our patient. Just see the condition of their mala. So, here two types of variation that is snigdha and ruksha. In dry eczema or in krura kosht, we should use snigdha virechan. In mrudu madhyam kosht or in our wet eczema, we should use ruksha virechan. So here, erandavrushta, Hrutabrushta Haritaki, Manibhadra Yog and Aragvat Pancha. That is a very good formulation, which are Purdhina. Even some of them are Rasayan and Virechan also. We should not use Bhedaniya drugs like that. Otherwise, it will create Vata Prakop in some patients. Narajisthadi Narachun also give Anuloman Parma. So the next one is Ruksha Virechan, where Patol Katu Trayadi Kashai, Bruhat Manjishthadi, Patol Muladi and Trifla with different Anupans are useful. I am also using in Snigdha Virechan Trifla with Aragvat, and another is in Ruksha Virechan, that is Nuhi Bhavi Trifla. So it is also good. You can use your choice of Virechan, but please see the Snigdha and Rukshata of the Dravya. Also, there is one formulation in market, that is Aragvat Kampilak AK pills. It is also very good. Now, this is the Vyadhi Paratva Chikitsa, that is Pushthagna Kandugna. As per our Pushthagna Mahakashai, I am selecting formulation according to patient. Again, Trifla, Bidang and Aragvat are good in itching or even Kushta, like in Vicharchik also. Darvi, Khadir and Nimbakwat and Panchanimba Churna, which are mostly used in my clinic. Kandugna, because this is most important, itching is main factor for any of the dermatitis. So Kandugna Mahakashai is also very good. That is mainly Pitta dominant Kandu. The another is Nimbakaranj and Aragvat. Haridra, Daru, Haridra are best Kandugna. Khadir is, you all know that it is the best Pushthagna. Same one is Darvi, Khadir and Nimba Kwath is good, and Panchanimba Chuna again is, it is also Kandugna. So these are all Kandugna internally. You can use as a Ghritpan, as a powder, as a Vati formulation or as a Kwath formulation. Now Swedajanan Karma should be considered in some of our patients. So Manjishthadi and Pribhuvan Kirti or Sudarshan Dhanvat even. Now, we will go with Ras Rakta Pachak. So mainly Ras Pachak, Rakta Pachak, which are used in Maharashtra mainly, in Panchabhautik Chikitsa also. And Manjishthadi Kwath, Arogyavardhini, Khadirashtak and Khadirarishtra. So they all are work on Rakta Dushti treatment. Also Sariva, single Sariva Ghanvati, and Manjishthadi Ghanvati also plays good role in eczema. Sorry. Sariva serve is one of the best choice in eczema, where we can see sung in any of our patients. Wish her treatment. This is most important for irritant and allergen, where Dashang Lep or Dashang Agar can be used internally, externally. Second one is Dushi Vishari Agar. Third one is Bilwadi Agar or Bilwadi Gutika and Bruhat Manjishthadi Kwath. So we should consider this Kwath for any of internal or external Visha, or we can found any of the toxicity. And in the Google, Panchatikta Grut Google, Keshwar Google and Amrutadi Google are in good choice in our Kledajanya Kushtha patients. Sorry for the interrupt. This all are Hetu Pratinikchikitsa and Vyadhi Vipreet Pratinikchikitsa. Now, if our patient will be recovered with the eczema or dermatitis, now we have to focus on Rasayanan or Punarbhog Chikitsa. So here, the one of the best choices is Haridra Khanda. The second one is Gandhak Rasayan. Third one is Sariva, because Sariva is again Kandugna Pushthagna, but it is Rasayan also. So you can use Sariva Ghanvati. And the fourth one is Guduchi Ghanvati, because overall Guduchi will also work on Rakta, Ras Rakta mainly. So after treating your patient, we should consider any of one of the formulation for next 3 to 4 months as a single Dravya, single formulation, right? And Ras Aushadhi, I am only using Ras Manikya in such type of patient. I am not the keen for Ras Aushadhi mainly. I can give my result in herbal plants only. So rasamanik only I use once or twice. Now external, because external is also most important for our symptoms. Arak tail is one of the best oil. We can see result. Arak, Haridra and Sarshav tail, it is made from this container. The second one is, the one formulation is there, and that is Nimbadi oil. It is, Nimbadi oil is Anubhut Yog. And in Nimbadi, there are four ingredients. 1 minute, I will tell you. The ingredients is Nimba. The second one is Haridra, Durva and Yashti Madhu. Four ingredients are there. And that is really best in Vicharchita. So Ark Tail, Nimbadi oil. Third one is Nalaparamadi oil. You all know that it is made from so many South companies. And Satudhodhrit in Pitt Pradhan dry eczema. In xerotic eczema also. And the fourth one is Nimbu oil, plain Nimbu, Karanj, Gandhak Druti, Gandhak Malhar and Jivantyadi Yama. So Satudhodhrit and Jivantyadi Yama should be used on xerotic, dry or neurodermatitis like conditions or pit dominant stage. External Parishakin Dhavan with Trifladi Kasha and Lodra Sevyadi Kasha, it is mentioned in classical texts. Now after all this, generally we are facing one problem is our patient hyperpigmentation or hypopigmentation pattern. Generally in Vicharchita we will see hyperpigmentation more. So in such patients we have to do vernier chikitsa or the complexions or skin pigmentation ke liye hame treatment dena padta. So in eczema, Kalyanak Bharut, it is one of the best grip externally after completing all our treatment, that is Sariva Manjista and Haridra, and because of that is blackish discoloration. Even Kandu and Garhar means Vishhar, that is Vishahar, that is used external internal as well. The second one is Eladi Tail. It is also good in Vata Kapha Pradhan condition. Yashti Madhu oil and Kumkumadi oil. So you can use it after our eczema treatment only for the pigmentations. Now coming to the case studies, I will show you first the first case, and this is neurodermatitis as per the allopathic doctors, dermatologist. Patient that is a female, 60 year old patient, more than 15 years. She is facing eczema in the initial stage, wet eczema, and later she developed neurodermatitis, that is lichen simplex chronicus. And since 15 years she is treated with so many dermatologists. The main symptoms when she came in the clinic is profuse itching. The second one is hyperpigmentation. You will see in the next photos. Lichenifications, sometimes oozing, and leathery texture, it is raised and rough patches, and any hydrosis means a swedana. So in the treatment part, you can see in the photo, the first one is right and left leg reddishness with swelling and itching, discoloration, lichenification, and some watery parts are there in the new patches. After 3 months, blackness and slightly itching decreases. Initially we did Vaman. The second one is Virechan. After that, because of psychological involvement and Koshta Dushti means there's a Vibandh are there sometimes. So we do Basti Chikitsa and later leech therapy. So after leech therapy, we see the drastic changes because of previously we did Vaman, Virechan and Basti three simultaneously. And later Rakta Mokshan with leech. After 10 months, there was no itching and darkness. And darkness also reduced. Right now, we are only focusing on hyperpigmentation stage and no recurrence in the last 5 months. So here, this is before and after 10 months. And why I'm giving this case? Because this is the most difficult cases in our Ayurvedic Ayurvedic clinical histories, because normal eczema we can treat easily, but this one is very difficult. and in modern in the allopathy doctors, we are consulting our dermatologists also in some of our cases, and we are referring some cases if we cannot treat properly. So that is a mutual understanding, and he also referred such type of patient to us because they don't have any of the treatments in the LSC, neurodermatitis. So here, woman, classical woman, and Virechan, we use Panchatikta Gripa after Niram condition and Snuhi Sade Tripla in the Virechan day. In the Basti, mainly Kalbasti and Panchatikta Kshir Basti in the later stage, and Rakhtamokshan, which leech. Okay, so now the second one is, this is a new machine what we developed with the help of one PhD scholar in physics, that is scientist from America, that is Plas Juvent. This is new machine and very small to handle it. What the concept is that I will show you the case result first, and then we will little discuss about the plasma therapy. This is plasma therapy, Plas Juvent. Plasma is not our blood plasma, but it is a fourth stage of state of matter, that is liquid, gas, and the fourth one is plasma. What plasma do? That emits ROS and RNS, means our reactive oxygen species and reactive nitrogen species. So work as antioxidant externally. This is only external therapies. Either of allopathy or Ayurvedic doctors with that treatment, they can use it externally because this is only external treatment. What this machine will do or the plasma will do, they will kill bacterial, fungal or any viral infection from outside and only for locally, not from inside. So only 1 minute treatment each time on each patient, and on alternate day or on the weekly basis, we can consider the patient to call for 1 minute treatment only. As per Ayurvedic view, we consider the machine and the mode of action, it is actually Rasa Dhatugat Dipan Pachan stage. Because when you all know the free radical theory, right? And we know our AMA theory. So here, reactive oxygen species and reactive nitrogen species are actually our Dipan Pachan stage, but it is coming from external side. And in the local level, in the Rasa Dhatugat Dipan Pachan, we are doing. And here you can see the difference in only third day. So first one, first picture is untreated. So first day picture, after third treatment, means third sitting, this is only external. Internal medicines, what doctor is doing, they are continuing this, right? So only three treatment, we can see the difference in the skin texture. And the second, it's the same with same machine, in the nail and the periphery of the nail, local is fungal infection and outside eczema also there. So two together. And you can see after a fourth day, actually the difference is there. So this machine is used as a first time it is used in India. And this is an innovative way where we can use on skin, even diabetic wound, ear, vaginal, genital, hair or skull and surgical site also. And work on bacterial and fungal infection. So why I tell you about this, because sometimes we are only doing our limited zone in our limited work, but this is also our science. According to Ayurvedic principle, we can use this as a Dipan Pachan Karma, Dhatugat Dipan Pachan. So here there are cases 1, 2, and 3 which I feel that I can share with you. Thank you for listening to